Hello everyone, my name is Ben Boston. I live in Montreal, Canada, and I have a great passion for organic food and sustainability. Today is December 1st, 2019, a day of the year that is particularly dear to me. As we are entering another cold and long winter in our region, I would like to share with you three pretty good news. And I would dare to say that if you will like this news and will decide to implement them together, they can generate some significant improvements in our lives. So let's get started. Everyone in Canada and other cold climate regions in the world knows that, with a few regional exceptions like South Ontario and West British Columbia, in Canada, delicious and organic fruits like the ones in these images are impossible to grow locally and eat fresh. Now, the first good news is that all the fruits shown in these pictures have been grown and harvested in the province of Quebec, Canada, in climate zone 4. In other words, growing a much larger variety of fruits than what the local climate zone allows us is possible. The second good news is about how that is possible. Considering that in climate zone 4, the minimum winter temperatures can drop as low as minus 29 to minus 34 degrees Celsius, or minus 20 to minus 30 Fahrenheit, it is obvious that none of the fruits mentioned earlier could grow outside. So the obvious solution would be to grow the fruit trees inside a greenhouse, creating what we like to call an indoor orchard. Now, some of you may know a lot about greenhouses, while some may not know much. But there is one very important thing that we should all understand about greenhouses. If we have to heat them, whatever we grow in those greenhouses becomes quite expensive. Moreover, apart from the high operation cost of a heated greenhouse, we also have to be aware that unless that heating comes from a renewable source of energy, a heated greenhouse is quite far from an ecological or sustainable system. As an illustrative example in this respect, the Low Tech magazine mentions in an article that in 2013, in the Netherlands, the approximate 10,500 hectares of greenhouses used a quantity of natural gas for heating equivalent to about half the amount of fossil fuel used by all Dutch passenger cars that year. So coming back to our fruit trees, if the fruits shown in these pictures would have been grown in a heated greenhouse, they could have easily become cost and energy prohibitive. Now, the second good news is that after a bit more than 7 years of intense experimental work, I have built and tested an unheated greenhouse that can enhance the local climate zone by 4 zones. So, for example, our experimental greenhouse, located about 100 kilometers from Quebec City, transforms the local climate zone 4 into an indoor environment similar to climate zone 8. As a result, I named this greenhouse solution a plus 4 zones greenhouse. As a concrete illustration, here are a couple of pictures taken last year on April 11, 2018, outside of our greenhouse, showing, as you can see, still winter conditions in our region that moment of the year. And then a moment later, another couple of pictures inside the greenhouse showing some beautiful apricot trees in full bloom. And then the same trees in July carrying beautiful apricots. So this unheated greenhouse allowed us to grow fruits that have never been grown before in the cold climate of our province, such as cherries, apricots, peaches, nectarines, figs, and table grapes. And that would be possible for any other cold region in the world with climate zone 3, 4, or 5. The same type of greenhouse that would be built in a temperate region with climate zone 6 or 7 would allow people to grow lemons, oranges, mandarins, and grapefruits. And also people living in a bit warmer regions with climate zone 8 or 9 could grow mangoes, avocados, pineapples, bananas, and practically any other tropical or subtropical fruits, all without any heating. Now, the third good news is that, surprisingly, growing fruit trees in a greenhouse has several significant advantages over growing them in the field. And one of them is that it makes it easier to grow 100% organic fruits. In this respect, I have searched and analyzed the various organic growing methods that people are using or trying in different parts of the world. And then I realized that one of these methods has a quite appealing advantage. It is self-sustainable. So I have implemented and have been applying this method on our fruit trees in the last 3 years, and the results so far have been excellent. These are the three good news I wanted to share with you, and I hope I did not exaggerate their merits. I could also add three interesting aspects related to the specific design of the Plus4 Zones greenhouse. First, this greenhouse is not a high-tech solution. It is relatively simple and affordable to build. Second, this greenhouse facilitates a high productivity, allowing us to grow at the same time fruit trees and also a good deal of vegetables, which actually turns it into an indoor garden and orchard. Third, I would say the Plus4 Zones greenhouse is actually quite nice looking, as it does not totally resemble a typical greenhouse. Now, all this said, as you may remember, at the beginning of this video I mentioned that if you would like this news, more specifically the idea of creating indoor organic orchards inside thermo-efficient unheated greenhouses, which would allow us to grow fruits that could not otherwise be grown in a cold or temperate climate. So if you like this idea and we will decide to implement it together, that can generate some significant improvements in our lives. Personally, I deeply believe this, but I would like to hear your opinion about it. I actually think this is so important that it's worth discussing in much more detail. So I will prepare another video with some more images of our indoor orchard and experimental greenhouse, and I will also share my thoughts of how we can all benefit from this organic and ecologic solution. Before we end, I would like to show you a few pictures of some of the young fruit trees that we had the joy of growing in the last few years in the province of Quebec, Canada, in Climate Zone 4. Thank you for watching.